Hello, I'm Zach Zenner. I was a football player from Eagan, Minnesota. I was also a three-time All-American and earned a NCAA postgraduate scholarship. Join me for another installment of A Decade of Excellence.
Down the middle 20, inside the 10, to the 5, to the end zone.
Hand off to Carlson. He'll penetrate right down the lane, running left, finger roll for two.
Slapped half quarter at the buzzer. 2013-2014 saw the Jackrabbits dominate the Summit League. We won the women's and men's all-sports trophies, plus the Commissioner's Cup, and we had a record number of all-conference, all-American, and academic all-American selections. If I had to pick one athlete who stood out most, it would have to be cross-country's Trent Lusignan. He grew up just 20 miles from me in Shakopee, Minnesota, and seemingly left at least that much distance between himself and his competition. He led our men's team to its fourth Summit League title in 5 years. He won the meet himself, his third top 10 finish at that conference meet. He was chosen as Cross Country Athlete of the Year and the championship MVP. He followed that up by becoming the first Jackrabbit to qualify for the NCAA championships in Division I. He earned All-American honors by finishing 12th at that national meet, which was a tremendous accomplishment. Things didn't look great at times for our football team. We started 4-4, but won our last four regular season games to make the playoffs for the second straight year, and our defense was dominant in an opening round win at Northern Arizona. Speaking of defense, cornerback Winston Wright was exceptional. Teams didn't even want to throw in his direction. He was that good. But when they did, the result rarely favored them. He was chosen as an All-American for his efforts on the field. Additionally, Winston was selected to the Good Works team. The Good Works team is a prestigious honor that looks across all levels of football to select 22 people who are active in their community through volunteer projects. Winston was honored to be selected, as was I the following year, and that really speaks to the program that Coach Stig has built here, giving back to the community. The honors kept coming for our football team. Tackle Brian Witzman and myself joined Winston as All-Americans. And Jason Schneider and I were academic All-Americans. We had six academic All-Americans throughout the department. Swimmer Phil Albu, high jumper Kaylee Olson, and Braden Carlson and Jordan Dykstra of men's basketball were also honored nationally for their grades in the classroom. Women's basketball won 26 games, losing only once in the Summit League en route to a conference championship. The team beat nationally ranked Penn State in December in Frost. Aaron Johnson was the conference coach of the year, and they made a deep run into the WNIT, beating Butler, Creighton, Minnesota, and Indiana, all here in Brookings. Men's basketball recorded one of the craziest road wins you'll ever see. They were down 5 with 21 seconds left at Denver when this happened.
Carlson looking, he gets it into Dykstra left corner, who will dribble once, contested 3 left wing, and he got it! And a timeout to the Jacks. Love trying to get it in, runs the baseline, allow it to make court. Larson steals. Carlson, left wing, Dykstra, 3 for the lead. Good! With 12 8/10 of a second left.
They won that game 74-73. Wrestling had 3 national qualifiers: Joe Brewster, Alex Kocher, and Cody Pack. 2 more individual honors. Equestrian's Ravian Scott was an All-American in reigning, and Hudson Carpenter led the league in stroke average during the Summit's Golfer of the Year Award. 5 Jackrabbits claimed individual track and field championships, one being Mary Worth, who went on to Eugene, Oregon, and finished 12th in the NCAAs in the high jump, which was good enough for All-American certification. It was our 6th year of Division I, but after all we had accomplished, you could argue that it was our best year yet. As I mentioned before, we swept the Summit League's overall awards, winning the women's all-sports, men's all-sports, and Commissioner's Cup trophies, with men's cross-country and women's basketball claiming championships. 6 All-Americans and 6 more academic All-Americans. 300 academic All-League picks. 103 All-Conference athletes. And our cumulative grade point average was 3.227. One last item. In May, Governor Dennis Dugard signed Senate Bill 15. This authorized construction of the new home for Jackrabbit football, Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium. And without this bill, and the efforts of President David Chiquin and Athletic Director Justin Sell, and the lead gifts from Dana Dykehouse and T. Denny Sanford, none of this is possible. It was a really good year, but we were only halfway through our 10-year run of excellence, so stay tuned for more. And remember, go big, go blue, go Jets.